Well, that was really weird because I was asked through my father, who knows everybody. He was a friend of Charlie Thomas, who was the head of, at that time, of Monsanto, and a very sort of charismatic figure. He was a wonderful man, actually. It was before all the miserable things that they are found doing. And he invited me to give a talk, and I suspect that it was arranged through my father, who said, "I've got a son that does this, that, and the other thing." And so I gave a talk at Monsanto. And after the talk, it's this colonel, all done up in his fancy colonel clothes, came up to me and said, "What's your draft status?" I said, "Well, it's pretty grim. It won't be long now." And he said, "Well, would you like to work in a laboratory?" And I said, "Of course." And she said, "Well, I'll tell you exactly what to do, how to get to my lab, which was in Dayton, Ohio. It's the Aeromedical Lab." And so I spent the war there. And it was wonderful in some ways because I learned an incredible amount of high altitude physiology. Not that that helped me with SIMOLs, but it helped me in teaching a lot. And so I could talk about something else besides SIMOLs. And he says how he arranged that I would come there. And I remember this very clearly because I thought I'd call on him and say, "I'm here." But there was no opportunity. And so I was given one of the jobs I was given by the sergeant, was to mop out the colonel's office. I remember this awful feeling that I can't greet him with a mop in my hand, saying, "Hey, I'm a genius with a mop." And so I hid the mop right behind the door and went in, and he wasn't there, so I was able to mop his office out without embarrassment.